Good day, everyone. The topic of our lecture today, the structure of nucleus. Nucleus. Nucleus is an essential organelle typical for eukaryotes. Function of nucleus: storage of genetic information, and second function, regulation of all vital processes in the cell. Nucleus consists of four parts: nuclear envelope, nucleoplasm, chromatin, and nucleoli. On this micrograph, you can see nucleus. Around nucleus, you can see nuclear envelope. Into the nucleus, you can see chromatin, heterochromatin, and euchromatin, and the center dark point, nucleoles. Nuclear envelope is formed by two membranes. Outer membrane is often a continuation of the granular endoplasmic reticulum and bears on the surface of the ribosome. Inner membrane is smooth. It enters into a complex with the internal structure called lamina, involved in maintaining the shape of the nucleus and the packing of chromatin. Lamina consists of intermediate filaments. You see nuclear envelope on this picture, outer membrane and inner membrane, and complex of nuclear pore. Nuclear pores. Nuclear envelope contains numerous nuclear pores. Each pore consists of a ring of proteins with a central channel, the whole complex being circuit and stabilized by the nuclear lamina. Nuclear pores regulate the extent of metabolites, macromolecules, and ribosomal subunits between nucleus and cytoplasm. On this picture, you see outer membrane, inner membrane of nuclear envelope, and complex of nuclear pores. Green color, you see intermediate filament of nuclear lamina. Next component of nuclear, chromatin. Chromatin is a complex of DNA with histone proteins. Remember, there are 9 of histone proteins: 4 paired, A to A, A to B, A 3, and A 4, and 1 unpaired, A 1. 8 proteins form a globular structure, octamer. Around each octamer, almost twice the DNA helix is wound, forming a nucleosome. And you see complex of 8 proteins, 4 paired proteins, A to A, A to B, A 3, and A 4, together 8 protein, This complex is called octame. And DNA, DNA helix is wound, forming a nucleosome. Octame with DNA is called nucleosome. DNA between nucleosome is called link DNA. And DNA between nucleosome enters the complex with the ninth protein histone 8-1. 8-1 take part to the first DNA packaging. This level of DNA packaging is called a nucleosomal level. There are eukromatin and heterochromatin. Eukromatin is almost not visible in the light microscope and contains functionally active DNA, from which can read information. Heterochromatin has the form of grains and clumps in the light microscope, contains functionally inactive DNA. Reading of information does not occur. On this slide, you see nucleosomal level of packaging of DNA. You see nucleosome. After that, nucleosome form chromatin fiber. It's next level of packaging of DNA. The DNA double helix forms a filament diameter of 2 nanometer. And you see short radian of DNA double helix, diameter 2 nanometer. Each script onto octame and forms nucleosomes. Nucleosomes are part of the nucleosomal filament with a diameter of 11 nanometer. And you can see structure beads on a string. Form a chromatin, each euchromatin level. Nucleosomal filament is twisted and forms the chromatin fiber with a diameter of 30 nanometer. And you see chromatin fiber on this picture. Chromatin fiber forms looped domains with a diameter 300 nanometer. And you see loops domains, looped domains. More tightly packed loop domains form the condensed section of chromosome with a diameter of 700 nanometer. You see on this slide. And they are part of a metaphase chromosome having a diameter of 1400 nanometer. Each level of packaging of DNA. And you can see levels of packaging on DNA on this slide. Yeah? Number one, at the simplest level, chromatin is a double-stranded helical structure of DNA, diameter 2 nanometer. DNA is complex with histones to form nucleosomes. And you see yellow, it's histones 8-1. Each nucleosome consists of 8 histones protein around which the DNA wraps 1.65 times. A chromatosome consists of a nucleosome plus 81 histone. The nucleosomes fold up to produce a 30 nanometer fiber that form loops averaging 300 nanometer in length. The 300 nanometer fiber are compressed and folded to produce 25 nanometer wide fiber. A tight coiling of the 25 nanometer fiber produces the chromatids of a chromosome. So you see DNA, nucleosome level, level of chromatin fiber, level of looped domains, and after that, chromatid form. A nucleolus. Into the nucleus, you can see nucleolus. What is nucleolus? You see electron micrograph, nucleus, and nucleolus in the center. Nucleolus is an electron-dense body, is a place where accumulate a large number of organic materials. Copies of ribosomal RNA, ribosomal proteins. Also large and small subunits of the ribosome around the fragment of DNA encoding ribosomal RNA. The function of the nucleolus is the formation of ribosomes. Nucleolus are heterogeneous structures. There are the pilar areas being the sites of DNA which code ribosomal RNA, and the dark areas being the places where of partially assembled ribosomes. The many different ribosomal proteins are imported from the cytoplasm and conjugated with the ribosomal RNA to form the ribosomal subunits, which then pass into the cytoplasm before being assembled into fully active ribosomes. So you must remember main parts of nucleus, nuclear envelope, nucleoplasma is a liquid content of nucleus, chromatin and nucleolus. Next question of our lecture, bacteria. Structure of bacteria and function of bacteria. What is bacteria? Bacteria are single-celled organisms. They are prokaryotes. Bacteria cells have no nucleus. The circular double-stranded DNA is free located in the cytoplasm. Bacterial DNA form a complex with a non-histone protein forming nucleoid. On this picture, you see structure of bacteria and green nucleoid in the center. You can see also purple point in the cytoplasm of bacteria, it's ribosome. And electronic micrograph of bacteria, you also can see nucleoid in the center of bacteria. Nucleoid of double-stranded circle DNA of bacteria with non-histone protein. Bacteria cell surrounded by an outer membrane. Envelope of bacteria. But you see cytoplasm surrounded by plasma membrane, and you see plasma membrane on this picture. The cell wall is surrounded outside of the membrane, what you see cell wall, and comprise a polysaccharide murine. Some bacteria may be covered with a mucose capsule. And you see on the slide purple mucose capsule. Also, you can see cytoplasm in the center, double-stranded circle DNA of bacteria with formed nucleoid, ribosome, and additional DNA plasmid. Also, pili and flagella. Bacteria don't have a membrane organelles. Bacteria don't have endoplasmic reticulum, don't have Golgi apparatus, lysosome, mitochondria, blastid. These organelles are absent in cytoplasm of bacteria. Bacteria have no cell center, microtubules, microfilaments. Bacteria have only 70S ribosome. Remember, ribosome of eukaryotic cell, 80S. Bacteria has more smaller ribosome, 70S. Some bacteria may have flagellum. You see flagellum on this slide. The bacterial flagellum has a simple structure. No microtubule in flagellum. Remember, eukaryotic flagellum consists of a complex of microtubule. Bacterial flagellum is a protein strand and unlimited membrane. And on this picture, you see again membrane of bacteria, cell wall, mucose capsule, plasmid, additional DNA, double-stranded circle DNA, or a nucleoid, or a bacterial chromosome, cytoplasm, and a lot of ribosome, 70S. And this picture, repeat. It's nucleoid region or a bacterial chromosome, additional DNA plasmid, cytoplasm, plasma membrane, cell wall, and mucose capsule, or a slime layer. Maybe food granule inclusion and prokaryotic flagellum. You cannot see membrane organelle, and you cannot see more parts of non-membrane organelles. No cellular center, no microtubule, no microfilaments. Now again, inclusion, capsule, cytoplasm, ribosome, nucleoid, nuclear area containing DNA, plasmid additional DNA, flagellum, pili, plasma membrane cell wall and mucose capsule, and electronic micrograph of bacteria. The shapes of bacteria. Prokaryotic cells have various shapes. The four basic shapes of bacteria: cocci, spherical, bacilli, rod shape, and you see cocci maybe cocci, diplococci, when you can see two cocci, diplococci encapsulated with capsule, streptococci is chain of coccus, sarcina, tetrad, and staphylococci. Bacilli, rod shape, maybe coccobacillus, bacillus, diplobacillus, palisades, streptobacillus. Spirochete, spiral shaped. And you see what spirochete on this picture. And vibrio, coma shape. For example, on this picture. То есть bacterial shapes are very different. And you see a lot of different shapes of bacteria on this picture. By way of nutrition, bacteria can be divided into autotrophic and heterotrophic organisms. Autotrophic bacteria are divided into photosynthetic bacteria and hemosynthetic bacteria. Heterotrophic bacteria are divided into parasites, saprotrophs, and symbionts. And on this slide, you can see example of photosynthetic bacteria. For example, Anabena. Anabena has photosynthetic cell, heterocyst for nitrogen fixation, and Akinet, dormant spore-forming cell. And you see structure of heterocyst, nitrogen-fixing cell, DNA, cytoplasm, photosynthetic cell has thylakoid for photosynthesis, ribosome, 70s cell wall, hemosynthetic bacteria. Chemosynthetic bacteria use chemical reactions between inorganic substances to generate energy, which they use to synthesize organic substances. And you can see different type of chemosynthetic bacteria. For example, hydrogen bacteria use this reaction to generate energy. Colorless sulfur bacteria use this reaction to generate energy. Iron bacteria and nitrate bacteria. And you see process of chemosynthesis. For example, sulfur bacteria, hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide, and water, and form sulfur compounds. And energy used for synthesis of sugar. Heterotrophic bacteria. The first type, bacteria parasites. They feed on living organisms and cause various diseases. For example, pneumococcus causes pneumonia. Vibrio cholerae is the cause of cholera. Helicobacter pylori can lead to development of stomach ulcers. And you see pneumococcus, Vibrio cholerae, and Helicobacter pylori. То есть коки, вибрионы, and спирули. Bacteria saprotrophs. They feed on the dead remains. These bacteria convert the organic matter of the dead bodies in minerals, thus closes the cycle of substances in nature. And third type of bacteria, heterotroph bacteria, the bacteria symbionts. These bacteria form a mutually beneficial relationship with other organisms. For example, some bacteria in the human colon helps to digest cellulose, creates an acidic environment where harmful bacteria and fungi do not develop, are involved in the formation of some vitamins. For example, vitamins group B and K. And on this slide, you see lactobacillus under the microscope. Bacteria can be divided into aerobic and anaerobic bacteria. An example of anaerobic bacteria is bacteria that live in the human intestine. An example of aerobic bacteria is putrefaction bacteria. We decompose dead organisms along the circulation of substances in nature. All bacterium survive in the form of spores in adverse condition and for a long time can survive. Reproduction of bacteria. Bacteria reproduce through asexual reproduction, usually by binary fission. And you see this process on this slide. You see bacterium, там cell wall, plasma membrane, DNA in the center. То есть, firstly, cell elongated and DNA is replicated. And you see two molecules of DNA. After that, cell wall and plasma membrane begin to divide. And cross wall forms completely around divided DNA. And cells separate. Bacteria don't have a sexual reproduction, but there is sexual recombination. And there are three types of sexual recombination: conjugation, transformation, and transduction. Conjugation, what is it? Some bacteria, in addition to the basic DNA, has additional DNA called plasmids. Donor bacterium having the plasmid may form cytoplasmic bridges by using sexual rod with a bacterium which has no plasmid. First, double-stranded plasmid DNA is separated into two chains. One of the chains is transferred to the recipient bacterium. Then each bacterium completes the missing chain on the principle of complementarity. And I want to watch you short film about conjugation of bacteria.
Bacterial conjugation is a process of genetic transfer between bacterial cells that requires direct contact between the cells. Many, but not all, species of bacteria can conjugate. Conjugation can occur between cells of the same species or even between cells of two different species. A small DNA circle or plasmid called the F factor is required for conjugation. The F factor stands for fertility factor. Strains of bacteria containing the F factor are called F plus. Those without it are called F minus. An F plus cell or donor produces a structure called a pilus to connect with another recipient cell. To begin conjugation, the F factor is cut at a specific region called the origin of transfer by a protein assembly called the relaxosome, which associates with a strand to be transferred, or the T-DNA strand. Accessory proteins of the relaxosome are released, but a portion of the relaxosome called the relaxase remains attached to the T-DNA. This T-DNA relaxase complex is recognized by a coupling factor and transferred to the exporter, a complex in the F-plus cell that is contiguous with the pilus. The exporter pumps the T-DNA relaxase complex into the recipient cell. Once the entire T-DNA molecule is transferred to the recipient cell, relaxase joins the ends to make a circular DNA molecule. As the T-DNA is transferred to the recipient cell, it is replicated to become double-stranded. In the donor cell, the F-factor DNA was also replicated to become double-stranded. This actually occurred as the T-DNA was being transferred to the recipient cell. In the end, both cells wind up with a complete double-stranded copy of the F-factor. Their connection through the pilus is released, and each is now an F-plus cell that can go on to conjugate with other cells.
And you see process of conjugation on this slide. Repeat. Donor cell attached to a recipient cell with each pilus, the pilus draw the cells together. The cells contact one another. one strand of plasmid DNA transfers to the recipient. The recipient synthesizes a complementary strand to become an F+ cell. The donor synthesizes a complementary strand, restoring its complete plasmid. And you will have two F+ cells. Second type of sexual recombination, transformation. Transformation is the transfer of a fragment of DNA from dead bacterium to living bacterium, where the fragment replaces the homologous site. Thus, a gene that provides resistance to antibiotics can pass from a dead bacterium, donor cell, to a living bacterium, recipient cell, that did not previously have this property. And you see this process on this slide. And next type of sexual recombination, transduction. The transfer of DNA fragments from one bacterium to another by using viruses, bacteriophages. Penetrating into the bacterial cell, the virus multiplies and forms a protein capsid. Sometimes virus capsid randomly encompasses fragment of bacterial DNA. This forms a transductive particle. When such a virus infects a new bacterium, it introduces into it not the viral DNA, but a fragment of the DNA of the first bacterium. And the second bacterium acquires new properties that the first bacterium had.
Specialized transduction involves the transfer of only a few specific genes from one bacterial cell to another by means of a phage. The lambda phage, which infects E. coli, is a well-studied example of a specialized transducing phage. When lambda phage infects E. coli, the phage DNA enters the cell and then integrates into a specific site on the host chromosome. When an E. coli culture carrying the lambda phage is induced, phage particles are produced. On rare occasions, a piece of bacterial DNA, for example, the GAL gene, near the specific site of insertion, remains attached to the phage DNA, and a piece of phage DNA is left behind. The phage that develop are defective because they do not carry the entire phage genome, but can still infect other cells. The defective phage can attach to another bacterial cell, and the DNA can be injected. Both phage and bacterial DNA now become integrated into the new host chromosome. Only bacterial genes located near the site of integration of the phage DNA can be transduced, hence the term specialized transduction.
And the last question of our lecture today, viruses. What is viruses? Viruses are organisms having no cellular structure. They consist of nuclear acid, DNA or RNA, which is surrounded by a protein shell called a capsid. Above the capsid may be located lipoprotein envelope, which often is a fragment of the membrane of the host cell, from which the virus was released. And you see on this slide structural bacteriophage and structural viruses influenza. Each virus has nucleic acid, DNA or RNA, and around protein code, capsid. Protein code of bacteriophage is very difficult. There is head, tail, fibers. Virus of influenza had protein code, and above of the capsid may be located lipoprotein envelope, which often is a fragment of the membrane of the host cell. And you see a lot of receptor on the surface of the virus. Metabolism, growth, and development are processes that are not typical for viruses. The protein-enveloped capsid of the virus consists of separate units, capsomeres. Capsomeres can form capsid of various shapes and symmetries. There are viruses with helical capsid symmetry, for example, tobacco mosaic virus, you see on this slide, or a cubic capsid symmetry, for example, herpes virus. On this slide, you see a lot of different shape of viruses. Virus of adenoviruses, influenza viruses, bacteriophage. It's cubic symmetry. And spiral symmetry, virus of tobacco mosaic. Viruses are permanent parasites that inhibit properties of living within the host cell. Heredity, variation, and reproduction are characterized for viruses. Outside the host cell, viruses behave like structure of inanimate nature. Therefore, viruses is a bridge between the animate and inanimate nature. And you see behavior viruses in the cell. Viruses are very specific. They penetrate only into the cell of a specific type. Viruses have the receptors to the specific cells. For example, hepatitis B virus affects the liver cells. The human immunodeficiency virus, HIV virus, affects blood lymphocytes. And on this slide, you see HIV virus, structure HIV virus. This virus has two chains of RNA, special enzymes, reverse transcriptase, protein capsid, and the lipoprotein envelope with a lot of receptors on the surface. The behavior of the virus in the cell. Firstly, virus recognizes the cell by using receptor. It then enters the cell by one of the methods. For example, animal viruses enter the cell by phagocytosis, and you see this process on the slide. Plant viruses and fungi viruses penetrate into the cell through the dividing cell wall. Viruses of bacteria, bacteriophages, enter the cell by induction. the main stage of the life of the virus. Firstly, absorption of virus on the cell. After that, penetration of the viruses into the cell. This help phagocytosis or a through damaged cell wall, or this help injection. Next state, deproteinization of the virus, the release of the virus from its envelopes. After that, synthesis of viral components, for example, replication of viral nucleic acid, and synthesis of viral protein that form the capsids. Next state, self-assembly on the virus, the viral capsid captures and surrounds the viral nucleic acid, and formation of viruses and their exit from the cell. And you can see this stage on this picture. This first stage, absorption of the viruses on the cell. After that, penetration of the viruses into the cell by phagocytosis. And you can see like phagosome forms. After that, phagosome joins with lysosome of cell, of host cell. And this help enzymes of primary lysosome, protein coat of viruses destroyed, and deproteinization of the virus occurs. And DNA or RNA viruses enter to the cytoplasm. After that, you see process of replication of viral nucleic acid and synthesis a viral protein capsid. After that, you see self-assembly of the virus, the viral capsid captures and surrounds the viral nucleic acid, and formation of viruses and their exit from the cell by exocytosis on this slide. The AIDS virus contains two strands of RNA and an enzyme called reverse transcriptase. And you see on this slide. First, a DNA strand complementary to the viral RNA is formed by the reverse transcriptase enzyme. То есть, firstly, you see penetration of the viruses into the cell, deproteinization of the virus, and RNA of virus, you can see into the cytoplasm. After that, with help enzymes reverse transcriptase, DNA strand complementary to the viral RNA is formed by the reverse transcriptase enzyme. And you see this process on this place. The DNA strand then forms a complementary second DNA strand. Thus, a double-stranded DNA fragment is formed. It travels to the nucleus, where it incorporated into the host cell's DNA molecule and function as a gene. After the virus is activated, it forms viral RNA and a lot of viral proteins. After that, self-assembly takes place and new viral particles are formed. And viral exit from cell with help exocytosis and surround plasma membrane of host cell. Once in the cytoplasm of the cell, the nucleic acid of the virus is copied many times. Organelles and materials of the host cell are used for this. The virus protein coat capsid is formed on the base of the viral nucleic acid. Then the self-assembly of the virus takes place, the viral nucleic acid passed into the capsid. As a result of the mate virus particle, virion is formed. Virions leave the cell either simultaneously or progressively by one. And you see same process on this slide. Absorption of the viruses, penetration of viruses into the cell, after the deproteinization, synthesis of viral component, to replication and synthesis of protein coat, and self-assembly of the viruses and form new viruses particle. Same process on this slide too. As a significance of viruses in nature and for human, viruses regulate the number of other living organisms. Viruses cause diseases in animals and plants. Scientists use viruses to create vaccines against diseases. Genetics use viruses as vectors to move genes. And in agriculture, viruses as a biological method of controlling plant pests. Now our lecture is over. I was glad to see you. See you later.